Now the next mode of nutrition is about heterotrophs. These group of organisms, they either depend directly or indirectly on other organisms for food to obtain their energy. And these group of organisms are classified into three types. They are saprotrophic, holozoic and parasitic organisms. So coming to the first category, saprotrophic organism or saprotrophs. Here the organism obtain their nutrition from dead and decaying organic matter, and they produce some kind of enzymes called as saprophytic enzymes, which break down the organic matter into simpler one. And the examples of such organisms are fungi, bread mold, yeast and mushroom. You would have seen the mushroom growing on damp wooden part, decaying wooden part, and they get their nutrition by breaking the complex form into simpler form by producing enzymes called as saprophytic enzyme. Even you would have seen the bread mold, after 2 or 3 days when you keep it in an unprotected condition, you can see the fungal growth on top of that. So thereby these group of organisms are called as saprophytes. The next category is holozoic organism. They ingest the food material, and after ingesting only they break down into tiny particles inside the organism. So the ingested food is broken down within the organism. An example for holozoic organisms are man, animals and amoeba. They intake the food, and after intaking they do the digestion process and breaking down into simpler part. Next, coming to the parasitic mode of nutrition, where the organism lives either on the body surface or inside the body. So these parasitic organisms, they require some kind of organism for survival. So they live on top of the organism, on the outer surface of the organism, or internally inside the organism, and get the nutrition directly from the host body. Example, chicks, leeches and tapeworm, or the example of the organism, parasitic organism, which thrive on other organism by living either outside or inside the body. Under heterotrophic mode of nutrition, about holozoic, this mode of nutrition. Under heterotrophic, as we have discussed already, we have three main types of nutrition. They are saprotrophic, holozoic and parasitic. We are going to discuss in detail about holozoic mode of nutrition, about amoeba and human beings. So amoeba paramecium are unicellular organism which undergoes heterotrophic mode of nutrition, where it engulfs the food particle completely and undergoes digestion process. After digestion, the waste product is thrown out of the cell. If you see amoeba, amoeba has finger-like projection called pseudopodia all over the surface of the body. So the finger-like projections you can see on the outer surface of the amoeba. So when it comes in contact with food particle, it forms a food vacuole. It tries to form a food vacuole. Inside the vacuole, the complex substance is broken down into simpler substance, and then this diffuses into cytoplasm, and undigested food is thrown out of the cell. So what happens over here? The amoeba engulfs the food particle and forms the food vacuole, and then they diffuse to the cytoplasm, and undigested food is thrown out of the cell. So you have one more example called paramecium, and paramecium, it is a unicellular organism which have cilia all over the body, and it also engulfs the food, ingest it and then digest it, finally throw out the unwanted particles out of the cell. The next detailed classification, detailed information is about human being, and we will discuss about human being, how they digest the food particle, how the food particle enter inside the human being in a stepwise process. Now, under heterotrophic mode of nutrition, the next example we are going to see about human beings. How human beings obtain energy from the food which is available outside the body. The process of intaking food through the mouth or any other source is called as ingestion. That is the definition for ingestion. Now, how about human beings? How do humans intake food? What is the entry point? The food enters through the mouth, and we all know about it. But we have to study about the stepwise process which takes place in complete digestion of
each nutrients we intake in the food. We all know the nutrients, carbohydrate, proteins, fats are the main nutrients which make up the food we intake. So these carbohydrates, proteins and fat, which are in the complex form, has to be broken down to simpler form. Like carbohydrates, which is in the complex form, has to be broken down to simple form. What is the complex form of carbohydrate? It is the starch. So the rice, what we eat, is made up of starch containing food, which has to be broken down into glucose, which is a simple form of carbohydrate. The second thing is protein. We intake protein from different kind of protein source, like legumes, pulses. And this protein, which is in the complex form, has to be broken down into simple form called amino acid. And third thing, fatty substance. So the fat containing food has to be broken down into simple fatty acid and glycerol. So we intake the food in the complex form, which has to be broken down into simpler form, which is not the easy process. It is a stepwise process which takes place in different parts of the digestive system of human beings or any other organism. Now, this full digestive system is called as the alimentary canal, which starts from the mouth and then to the esophagus, which is the food pipe we call as, and that leads into the bag-like structure called as stomach, and then from stomach it enters the small intestine. From small intestine to large intestine, and the undigested food is thrown out of the body through the anus. So we will discuss about each part of the alimentary canal in detail. So first one is mouth. So we all know, as soon as the food enters our mouth, you chew the food using our teeth, and the tongue helps us in complete mixing of the food with the watery secretion which is present in our mouth, and that is called as the saliva. So the watery secretion present in our mouth is called as saliva. So how this saliva is secreted? This saliva is secreted from the salivary gland which is present in the mouth. So what is the gland? When something is secreted, we call it as a gland, which we will be learning in further classes in detail about different kinds of glands present in our body and how it is controlled. Now, coming to salivary gland, produces saliva, and that contains an enzyme called as salivary amylase. Already I have given a small hint that heterotrophic mode of nutrition is a mode of nutrition where complex substance will be broken down to simpler substance using enzymes or biocatalyst. Most of the enzymes will end up with a word called as ASE. ASE means what? It enzyme has the word, like lactase, protease, maltase. So different kinds of enzymes help in converting complex substance to simpler substance. Now here, the food which has starch. Starch is complex carbohydrate, is broken down into sugar, simple sugar like maltose, for example, by the help of salivary amylase, which is present in the saliva, and that is secreted by the salivary gland. So this is the first step that is taking place in the mouth. Now, once we chew it completely, we swallow it. So this swallowing movement takes place called as peristaltic movement. The contraction, the rhythmic, we say rhythmic contraction and relaxation of the muscular movement which takes place throughout the alimentary canal is called as peristaltic movement. So here what happens, the mouth pushes the completely chewed food into the food pipe called as esophagus. When you touch your throat region, you can feel the food pipe. So this is the connection between the mouth and the stomach. So it is a long pipe which extends from mouth region to the stomach called as esophagus. Now food is pushed forward by peristaltic movement. Now what happens? The food has reached the stomach. So here no digestion takes place, only the pushing forward of the food to reach the stomach alone takes place. Now what happened? The food has reached the stomach. Now what happens in stomach? It is a bag-like bag-shaped structure which has gastric glands. Again, I have mentioned glands means secretion. It secretes certain substance called as glands. Now, it has glands surrounding the stomach. Now, what does these glands secrete? It releases HCl. HCl is called as hydrochloric acid, pepsin and mucus. Mucus is the layer which protects the inner lining of the stomach from the action of the acid. So, this is the role of mucus. And apart from that, we have HCl, hydrochloric acid, which provide an acidic environment to the chewed up food. And pepsin helps in breaking down of the protein content in the food substance. So, overall, these things help in further digestion of the food, in breaking down complex substance to simple substance. Already here, carbohydrate like starch is broken down into sugar. Here, pepsin helps in breaking down protein content into simple form of amino acid. So, it is a protein itself is a complex structure. It is made up of polypeptide. Polypeptide means long chains of amino acid linked together is called as polypeptide. It is not broken down in a simple step. It is converted into dipeptide and finally into amino acid. So, it is a stepwise process. So, this happens in the stomach. Now, after this digestion, the food enters the small intestine. So, till small intestine only, digestion will take place. Further, when it reaches the large intestine, no further digestion takes place. So, we will see what happens in small intestine, how further breaking down of food substance takes place.